200 sensational and original new candy bars, each one more sweeter, more creamy, and more delicious than the one before. I can make chewing gums that never lose their flavor and create rich caramels that change colors as they dissolve delectably every 10 seconds in your mouth. I've created the biggest and best candy empire the world has ever known. But I have no one to leave it to, no one to replace me, and no one to make new candy dreams come true when I retire. And the time for me to retire is already last long overdue. Please gather around, boys and girls. I have an important announcement to make.
Whatever your opinion is about.
chocolate world could not survive without me. There'd be no more chocolate ripples, or chocolate tipples, or chocolate rumbles, or chocolate bubbles, or chocolate kisses for sweet young misses. Soft and creamy, completely dreamy, our chocolate eyes, chocolate surprises will grow and grow and grow.
The day that I retire.
Candy!
What?
Candy!
Okay, you got them right here.
You gotta remember that Charlie's descended from a long line of distinguished candy men.
And women.
Wonka hasn't hired anybody since Slugworth. Spy stole that candy balloon recipe.
Oh, and Wonka was so angry. He gathered all his workers together and told them, "I'm sorry, but you all must go home." And then he closed the gates of his factory forever.
But Mr. Wonka still makes candy. I can smell them on my way to school.
Yes. But no one goes in. And no one comes out. Shadow workers.
Maybe the undead. Who knows?
Grandpa Joe, you're going to give the boys nightmares again.
Charlie?
We're playing gin?
I'm in.
Charlie, will you go outside and see if anybody's done with the day's paper?
Sure, but you'll have to feed Grandpa George.
Here, Pop. Here's your cabbage soup.
You see these kids here? They gather outside Charlie's house every day after lunch with a shiny nickel apiece to buy a Wonka bar from the local candy man. The only kid with no nickel is Charlie.
Not today. Should you eat it first?
Take away, Mama, rubbing a sigh, soaking in the sun and making
Chocolate Crispy, will you look at this? Wonka factory to be open to a lucky few.
You mean people to be allowed inside the factory?
Ooh, read what it says.
Willy Wonka has decided to allow 5 children to visit his world-famous chocolate factory. The lucky 5 will be able to tour the factory and receive a lifetime supply of Wonka chocolate.
A lifetime supply of chocolate?
Read on!
5 golden tickets will be hidden amongst 50 million ordinary candy bars.
Wow, that's a 10 million to one shot. Wow, I don't like those odds.
The finders of these golden tickets will win the tour and the chocolate.
What are you talking about?
Wonka's having a contest!
Why would he want a screen test?
A contest!
Who is it?
Wonka!
What about it?
He's having a contest!
Charlie, can you imagine winning?
Touring the factory.
Meeting Mr. Wonka.
Seeing for yourself all those undead zombie workers.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Eating a lifetime supply of chocolate.
Oh, 1 o'clock already? Charlie, you better hurry. You'll be late for school.
Well, it's back to the twists and turns of the toothpaste caps for me.
Goodbye, Mr. Bucket.
Goodbye, Miss Bucket.
Charlie, come here. Now remember, we may be starving.
Starving?
We may be poor.
Poorer than church mice.
But the Bucket family always thinks positive.
Charlie.
Yes, Grandpa George?
Come here. Come on over here.
What is it, Grandpa George?
We may be poor.
Yes, Grandpa George.
We may be starving.
We have already done that!
The Bucket family
always thinks positive. I know, Grandpa George. I know.
How do you know I was going to say that?
If it didn't happen, you'll never forget.
Yeah, positive.
So, Mr. Bucket went back to the toothpaste factory while little Charlie Bucket went off to school. But on the way, Charlie heard some exciting news.
Did you hear? Some kid already got the first golden ticket.
Already? When?
Hey, come on, guys.
Where the first golden ticket has been found. Here is the winning family now. Mrs. Poop! Mrs. Poop! May we have a few words?
Der Name is Gloop. Mit einer G, und einer O, und einer O, und another O, und einer P. Gloop. Und this is my kleine Lincoln Augustus.
Tell us about the ticket.
Yeah, just knew my little smudgy fudgy would find us golden ticket. He eats so much candy bandy, it's almost impossible for him not to find a golden ticket.
Impossible, yeah!
Now, Augustus, tell the folks at home something about you. What do you do? Any hobbies? Favorite subjects?
Yeah, food. Augustus eat food. Lots and lots of food, yeah!
Eating is his hobby. He eats so much food. Eating is something he loves to do. Isn't it, my pig wee wee wee?
Yeah, put it, Mommy, yeah, put it!
And what do we always say? Say it with me, Augustus. Eat more, eat more, eat more, eat more! Good much food. He has to be in training for it ever since he was a little boy.
Training?
Yeah, this was the Olympics. Augustus would have the gold medals. He eats so much. We give him fruit juice for breakfast, and turtles and gallons and melons and meadows and cream.
Tomatoes and mushrooms and pickles and bad spices and coffee and toast and with butter and marmalade, sweet meat and meat and meat galore.
And what does Augustus do when breakfast through?
I eat more! I eat more!
He eats bratwurst for lunch and it's the size of a truncheon and lamb chops and cooking too. I'm drinking my I'm getting a fitting, I'm blue. The luncheon begins at 12:45 and it ends at 4:15.
And what does Augustus do when luncheon's through?
I eat more, I eat more. Between meals, the cooks feed me all kinds of goodies, like chocolate and pudding and snacks. Mom has vodka bar sent him in sacks.
I make sure there is nothing he lacks.
Then dinner, of course, it's his meal of the day when Augustus comes right off his diet. There's hamburgers, hot dogs, and 10 tons of french fries.
And if I want more, they supply it.
Augustus keeps eating.
Eating.
Until he subsides to the floor.
And when he can finally get back on his feet, can a kid even fit through the door?
Why? That's why Augustus has lived in the dining room ever since he was 4.
So what does the poor lad do all night to prevent life becoming a bore?
I eat more, I eat more, I eat more, I eat more, I eat more.
Wonka bars. Me, I'm in the nut business. Peanuts, cashews, Brazils, macadamias. If it's nuts you want, I got them roasted raw, plain, or fancy. Folks go nuts for our nuts. Check us out at www.weirdnuts.com.
This is about me, Daddy. They want to know about my golden ticket, not your macadamias.
Right you are, dear. Right you are. Call us at 1-800-WEIRDNUTS. Major credit cards accepted.
The ticket, Mr. Salt.
Right. So I bought hundreds of thousands of Wonka bars and had my factory girlie stop shelling nuts and start shelling wrappers.
And how many wrappers did Veronica shell?
None, you pea brain. Veruca doesn't do manual labor. We have people for that. And my father will have you fired for mispronouncing my name, won't you, Daddy?
Whatever you want, Pigeon, whatever you want. Anyways, after days of shelling chocolate, one of my factory girlies finally found the lousy golden ticket. I just rewarded her by letting her take the lucky piece of chocolate home to her 17 kids. I just didn't have the heart not to. Know what I mean?
How philanthropic. Daddy, now she's being sarcastic. I want her fired. Fired, you hear me? Fired, fired, fired. This is Penelope Trout, where it seems the sweet is rapidly turning sour.
With nuts, don't forget the nuts.
Seems you can't have the chocolate without the nuts. Good luck, Veronica. My name is Veruca! So after just one day, there are only 3 golden tickets left. Stay tuned for continuous coverage of this extraordinary contest. Let's hope that just one deserving kid is among the five. Trout out.
You guys went to school. That's okay. You guys go without me.
Yeah,
why aren't you at work? Did they close the factory or anything?
That's an understatement, Charlie. They've closed it forever. I'm out of a job.
Out of a job?
Yeah, they moved everything overseas. It's going to all be automated. Being a toothpaste cap twister was the only thing I ever knew. I just don't know what to do.
You know what? Don't worry about it, Dad. You never liked that job anyway. And maybe now you can get back into the candy business like Grandpa Joe keeps talking about.
Grandpa Joe likes to dream big dreams, Charlie. But I'm afraid big dreams aren't going to put food on the table. I don't know what I'm going to tell your mom. You know, it was tough when I had a job. But
I now said, don't worry. Just think positive.
Be positive? Why?
Why not?
You've nothing to lose, so why not choose to think positive? Whenever I think I'm in the blink, I think positive. Whenever I'm feeling down and out and don't know what to do,
of them all.
Rio Whipple, carefully whipped at 2,700 RPMs for precisely 63.2 seconds.
Grandpa, please. I thought we decided on the Nutterific.
The Fudgemallow was the best, and you know it.
Nutterific.
Fudgemallow.
Nutterific, Nutterific, Nutterific.
Hey, I think he's terrific, too. Happy birthday, Charlie.
It's Charlie's day.
Open it up, Charlie.
Yeah, show us what thinking positive is all about.
Okay, here goes.
For goodness sakes, open it, boy.
Please open it, you're making me jumpy.
You're always grumpy. That woman was born grumpy, but I love her to the same.
Charlie, that's not funny. Tell me it's not true.
We'll starve!
It is true, and we are not going to starve. What kind of party is this? Let's splurge a little bit. Turn on the radio.
Mr. Bucket's right. What's a little bit more electricity? Charlie, turn on the radio.
Really? This is the best birthday ever.
Flash. In the past hour, a third golden ticket has been found in Snellville, Georgia. And what is your name, young lady?
Violet Beauregard.
Violet, quit chewing your gum so loudly. It's not ladylike at all. Do you remember what your therapist said about X now?
I can't, Mom. You slap your jaws any more than I do.
Now, Violet, dear, I don't appreciate that sort of language. Watch your words. Ask me nicely.
No problem. Hey, Mom, would you please can it? I'm being interviewed here.
Now, Violet, tell us about your ticket.
Normally, I'm a gum chewer. In fact, I adore gum. I love it, love it, love it. I chew gum all day long, except when I'm eating. Then I take the gum out of my mouth and put it behind my ear like this.
Isn't she clever? She came with that all on her own.
Mine, cool it. And when I sleep, I put the gum on my headboards from the morning. All I have to do is pop it back in my mouth and keep on chewing.
So clever.
Sometimes it's a little hard to get started, and one time I got it in my hair. Mom cut it out. I went right on chewing it. It was a hairy moment, though.
Isn't she just hilarious?
Very witty, Violet. Now, tell us about your ticket.
Okay, keep your pants on, Phineas, and get into it. So like I said, I'm a gum chewer normally. But when I heard about Wonka's contest, I laid off on the gum and switched straight on the candy bars. That's how I found the ticket. Now, of course, I'm right back on the gum. In fact, I've been working on this food for over 3 months solid. I've beaten the record set by my best friend Cornelia Prince Medal. Hi, Cornelia, listen to this. That's how you lose and list more. Chew on that Princess Prince Medal.
Up to over 200,000 an hour. And this just in, the fourth golden ticket has also been located in Television City, New Jersey. Leaving only the fifth and final ticket to be found, we are live at the home of Mike TV, lucky finder of golden ticket number 4. Here's Miss TV now. Tell us about finding the golden ticket, ma'am.
Yes, Mike and I here were...
Dad, cut the chit-chat, Mom. Didn't I tell you never to interrupt? This is the best part. Crack, smack, whack, dead. Did you see that guy die? It was so totally awesome.
So we gathered, Mike. Now, Miss TV, about the golden ticket.
Give it! This next show is the suicide bomb, dude. Wait a minute. Freeze frame. It's my cell phone. Talk to me. Hold on. Got another call. Talk to me.
Mike, would you mind telling us about the...
Dude, can't you see I'm busy running an empire here?
Gotta go. Catch you later. Okay, Oprah, what'd you want?
Mike, I'd like you to tell our audience how it feels to...
Hold the phone, dude! Check it out! I Well, I guess I got the big shiny ticket, dog. Big deal means I gotta give up half a day of all my favorite shows to tour some stupid chocolate factory, which will probably have crappy cell reception anyway. Forgive me, Oprah, baby. Gotta change the channel. Dude, check it out!
And which school does our latest golden ticket winner attend?
School! School? Are you joking? Or just crazy?
Crazy.
Who needs school? I got the net, my TV, and my Game Boy, fool.
Something like electric train, something like music ranks to earn a university degree. I don't share the thirst for knowledge, I don't need to go to college, me, I see it all on TV.
Some kids like to sing and dance while others go to Paris, France, and others visit Washington, D.C.
I don't learn a single thing, cause I can download anything, it's all on my computer for free.
Some kids go to baseball games while other kids have useless things like 10 days at a Boy Scout jamboree.
While wimpy kids read books of verse, I play Destroy the Universe. No one has Nintendo games like me.
Some kids like to fly balloons, so play the latest top 10 tunes while others want to surf in Waikiki.
I can visit London, Rome,
or Tokyo when they're leaving home.
Take a spaceship to the moon.
Get back on any afternoon.
Yes, we can do it all from A to Z. Cause I got my computer, and my Game Boy's even cuter.
Yes, we can see it
just one, please.
Okay, just one. But no zombie worker story. You need your rest.
You don't mind if Papa tells Charlie a bedtime story?
Guess not. I'll help you clean up, Mrs. Buck.
Okay, Charlie, have I got a story for you?
What's it about? Giant peach? Pirates? Zombies?
I promise your mom no more zombie stories. This one's about a special little boy. And it just so happens to be this little boy's birthday.
Yeah?
And this little boy thought he'd opened up all his presents, but there was one more. Charlie, look at this.
Another Rubik! But where'd you get it?
I have my ways. Now remember, this bar here, there's a small, teeny tiny, 10 million to one chance that it could contain fifth
and last golden ticket.
What's going on over there?
Pop, what y'all got in your hands over there?
Just a little something from me to Charlie. Keep it quiet. I don't want to wake the others.
What's going on over there?
I smell chocolate.
What are you up to, Joe?
This is between me and the boy. Now go on, Charlie. Open it.
Okay. I can't. I'm too nervous. You open it, Grandpa Joe.
I'll tell you what. Let's open it together on the count of three. A lifetime supply of chocolate.
One, two, three. Nothing.
A good thing, really. Chocolate, very fattening.
She's right. And why, with a lifetime supply of it, you'd be the size of a dome on Capitol Hill.
I wish I'd never heard of candy. Or Wonka.
Troubles go away. Love.
come, Charlie. No need to frown. Deep down, you know the world is still your toy. When the world gets heavy, never fear the pattern of an atom war.
Sub-Zero Choco Ice Cream Supreme. First came the snow, huge flakes drifting down from a steel blue sky. And then came the wind. Jets of cold air came rushing in between the windows, under the doors, and there was nowhere to go to escape them. The four old folks lay silently huddled together in their beds, trying to keep the cold out of their bones. For the Bucket family, the excitement of the golden ticket had long been forgotten. In fact, the only thing the family could think about was scraping together enough food to keep the hunger at bay for yet another cold, long day as winter tightened its grip. Mr. Bucket searched for odd jobs like shoveling the snow, while little Charlie Bucket began the long uphill trek toward school.
Charlie, where's your coat?
Oh, I haven't got a coat.
Here, take my scarf. You'll freeze to death.
Thanks. Making your rounds?
Was hoping to, Charlie, but it's too cold. Gotta get the candy back to the shop before it freezes. Help me back up, would you?
Sure.
Oh, blast it! My fingers are so cold I can't even feel them. Say, Charlie, would you pick up that box of nut crunchies for me?
Sure. Hey, there's something in the snow.
A silver dollar.
I think you must have dropped this.
Wow, a silver dollar? No, it's not mine. You should take it home to your folks.
You think I should? Maybe I should put up a notice or...
That coin's probably been in the snow for weeks. Take it, Charlie. And take this for being such a good kid. Really? You look like you're starving.
It's so good. It's a perfect blend of Belgian dark chocolate and New World Light. With subtle overtones of Moroccan espresso. Wonka's a genius. Well, I better get to school. Actually, do you think I could have just one more? And this one I'll pay for it.
Why not? I'd give you another one, but the boss is pretty strict on inventory. Will it be, Charlie, my boy?
Well, I think I'll share this one with my family. Grandpa Joe likes the fudge mallow, but Grandma Josephine likes the Nutterific, so...
Then you should try the Whipple Scrumptious Nutterific Totally Twisted Combo Bar. Just out. Here you go. sharing and all, but it wouldn't hurt to take a taste now, you know, just to make sure you like it too.
Thank you.
been traveling in the world of my creation. What we'll see will defy explanation. If you want to view paradise, simply look around. Want to change the world? There's nothing to it. There is no life I know to compare with your imagination. Living there, you'll be free if you truly wish to. questions?
Yeah, Wonks, how long do you think this will take? I've got a meeting in like 20.
Any questions for the children?
Mr. Wonka, how long until we may have a snack? He has low blood sugar, my Augustus.
Come on, Mike. Pose with Mr. Wonka. Come on. Pose with Mr. Wonka.
Oh, just wait till your grandma gets this. Oh.
There is absolutely no photography on this tour.
Mr. Wonka, just how many rooms does your factory?
Good question, Augustus.
In the Wonka Chocolate Factory, there are several thousand rooms. I'll show you what some of them are. This room here are the luminous lollies for eating in bed at night. And in that room there are exploding sweets for when enemies start a fight. In that room there is the rock candy mine that they say is 3 miles deep. And in this room here are the marshmallow villas to munch when you just can't sleep.
Little
big rooms,
high rooms,
low rooms,
1700 candy showrooms,
small rooms, tall rooms,
bathrooms, ballrooms.
You'll find chocolate in almost all rooms. In this room here are the chocolate cows from which we get chocolate milk. And in that room there are the hot ice creams for a cold day smooth as silk.
And in every room are chocolate miracles, treats beyond compare, driving rivals to despair.
You see them tear their hair, and all because of
this room here,
and this room here,
and this room here,
or this room here,
and that room here.
Oh yes, and that room there.
Super special chocolate is never to be touched by human hands, especially yours.
Achoo!
give his coal to millions of people.
It's so good. I think I'm chocolate getrunken. Augustus!
Seems not even I have need for a glucosized pipe.
Augustus, get out of that pipe this instant!
He looks like he's stuck.
He is stuck.
Oh my God, in Himmel, he is gestunken!
The suspense is building. I hope it never stops. 5, 4, 3, 2. We've had a quite early setback, I'm afraid. We lost a big, fat, greedy child to the Chocolate River. It really is a shame. The boy certainly seemed to know his food.
He'll be smashed like I'm a marshmallow.
Impossible.
That pipe goes nowhere near the marshmallow room. It goes to the strawberry dipping room.
Strawberry dipping room?
Yes, where he'll be heated to a temperature of 88 degrees Fahrenheit. Or is that Celsius? I do get the two confused so often, sometimes with tragic consequences. Anyway, somebody will accompany Mrs. Gloop to the strawberry dipping room, and when you get there, take a nice, long, sharp, pointy stick and start poking around in the mixing barrel. You're sure to find him in there. But don't wait too long, because he could make it to the fudge boiler, and that would be a tragedy. He could damage the machinery.
But Augustus, he will be damaged!
Frau Gloop, as far as I'm concerned, Augustus was damaged long ago. The rest of the tragedy is the wasted chocolate. Goodbye, Mrs. Gloop, and good luck. Now, if you will follow me, we will continue with the rest of our tour.
South.
Inventing room. This is the nerve center of my entire factory. All my most secret inventions are cooking and simmering in here. Oh, ta-da! The everlasting gummy gourmet gobstopper.
It looks like gum.
That's because it is gum. The most delicious gum in the world.
Gum? Oh no.
A delicious three-course meal, and without any of those nasty calories. But it's not been perfected yet, therefore, we must not chew it.
I only have one drink in life, there's very little to it. To own one stick of lifelong gum, and all lifelong to chew it. I chew it all through childhood, I chew it when I win. If I survive the 95, I chew it till I'm dead.
Gum here is much better than that one. This gum here is a three-course dinner. Pea soup, roast beef, blueberry ice cream. Blueberry is the nicest ice cream. You may feel fat, but in fact you're thinner. Even after a three-course dinner.
That gum is so much. It's delicious. It really tastes like pea soup. Oh, and here comes the roast beef. Fantastic. So tender and juicy.
But the blueberry ice cream.
I'll bet it's to die.
Oh, that's what I'm worried about. The die.
You'll buy the you're so busted.
That gum is gonna do it. Her candy fan's gone down the drain.
I asked her not to chew it.
Do I really nothing to it? Cause I know just how to chew it. There is no need to poo-poo it. All I have to do is do it. Violet, it's so bad for you.
But why is it doing? You're turning blue.
Violet, what you gonna do? Just stand there singing, am I blue?
Yes, she's turning blue. Blue, it's true. Oh, Violet, you are now bright blue.
I'm bright enough to go, I knew it. We were blue at the asteroid. I guess I'm blue. Blue.
children down. How delightful. It's a shame, really. The girl showed such promise as a gum-chewing prodigy.
Mr. Walker?
I couldn't get your bed off, but you're dead.
Will Violet ever be all right, or will she always be a blueberry?
Oh, very probably, or at least I hope so. You see, it's a shame, really, the girl did show such promise as a gum-chewing prodigy. Now, if you'll follow me.
I'm moved, I will be a darling, 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 I will be a darling. I'm moved, I will be a darling, 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 I will be a darling.
Now, if you'll follow along, there is so much sea to moor. Stop! Reverse that! Oh, I quite forgot about this room. It's the fizzy lifting drink room.
Bubbles! Do they taste like candy? Mr. Walker, sweet, I want bubbles that taste like candy.
Well, the bubbles actually taste like soap for children with dirty mouths. It's what the bubbles do that is remarkable.
What do they do, Wonka?
Well, just one taste of my fizzy-looking drink, and you will float on air.
Float on air? Whoa!
Yes, but my legal advisors have forbidden even taking the tiniest sip of it. Something to do with air traffic control. Now, if you'll follow me, I have so much more exciting things to show you.
Hey, where's Mr. Wonka and the other kids?
They left us behind.
Grandpa Joe, what's that?
Hello? Who's there?
Should we?
I suppose one tiny taste wouldn't do any harm.
Thank you.
Some chocolate nuts.
Oh. Why does it smell so bad in here?
TV thing yet? Now, what was my camera? You seen it?
No.
Where'd that little poor boy go?
Who?
I don't know. Maybe I imagined it.
Mr. Wonka, what makes your chocolate taste so good?
Oh, well, you see, Veruca, the cocoa bean has a primary saccharopsycho ingredients, the primary component being theobromine and caffeine. And now, if you follow along closely, we'll, Charlie, you try and stay with the group. We wouldn't want you to, float away now, would we? Oh, here we are! The nut room!
Wonka, are those squirrels?
Thus explaining their enormous similarity to squirrels. You see, these squirrels can separate a walnut from its shell in one piece, all while separating the good nuts from the bad.
They're so adorable! Here, Squirrely, Squirrely!
Veruca, do not distract the squirrels. They are in training.
See here, Wonka. I want a squirrel, and what I want, I get.
Checkbook ready?
I want a squirrel and an Oompa Loompa. I want a squirrel and an Oompa Loompa and a pink candy boat. In Wild at it, I want a feast. I want a bean feast. Cream buns and donuts and fruitcakes with no nuts. So good you can go nuts, give it to me. Now, I want a ball. I want a party. Pink macaroons and a million balloons and performing baboons and give them to me. Now, I want a party with room full of laughter. I want a ton of ice cream. And if I don't get the things I am after, I've got a prizes and sweets and surprises of all shapes and sizes, and now don't care how, I want it now.
She wants the world, she wants the whole world, she wants to lock it all up in her pocket.
It's my bar of chocolate, give it to me now.
She wants today, she wants tomorrow, she wants to wear my clothes in her hair,
and I don't want to share them, give them to me. Now, I want to ride in a fine crystal carriage, I want each day to be spring. And when the time comes to think about marriage, I want a
she wants the stars up in the heavens. Venus and Saturn arranged in a pattern.
Can't wait to wear that on my crown.
Don't care how,
I want it now. Don't care how, I want it now.
Bad.
But don't worry, there's a chance it may not be lit today.
A chance?
Yes, well, you see, it's usually only lit every other day, but I can't remember if today is that day or not. We'll see. And it's a shame, really. The girl was so deliciously bossy, thoughtless, self-centered, and uneducated. She would have made a wonderful politician. Oh, well. Onwards and upwards, backwards and forwards. Please exit this way. I will be with you in a moment.
Oh.
Other than that, the day has been a total waste of time.
and chocolate. Good luck, Charlie, and goodbye.
Goodbye, Mr. Wonka. Actually, just a moment. I don't deserve a lifetime supply of chocolate. I broke the rules, and I drank the gluten drink, and I'm really, really very sorry. But thank you for the most wonderful day in tour of your factory. It was better than Christmas.
Bless you, Charlie. You did it. You just did it.
Did what, Mr. Wonka?
Now, see here, Mr. Wonka. It wasn't Charlie. It was my idea. I'm the one that suggested we taste the fizzy lifting drink.
Okay, so then you're both to blame. But I haven't got time to worry about that now. You see, I created this whole thing with one purpose in mind. To find the perfect person to make new candy dreams come true.
I don't understand.
You see, it was a test of character, Charlie. I chose each of the rooms that would tempt each one of our golden ticket winners. And you did something very special. You gave into temptation and were smart enough not to get caught, and then admitted your guilt anyway. Now, if you follow along, we got so much planning to do.
Does this mean we're in trouble?
I'm not, but you could be, Charlie. You'll find it's just a matter of time till you find yourself in some good old-fashioned life-threatening trouble. Here we are. All right, go ahead, Charlie. Press that button way up there.
This one?
No! That one.
Where are you taking us, Mr. Wonka? I thought the tour was over.
Oh, that tour? That tour was just cotton candy and treacle design. Our tour is just beginning. Go ahead, Charlie. Press that button. No! No! No. That one. Good. Here we go. We're going up and out.
Up and out?
Whee!
We're flying, we're flying.
My favorite pastime.
Much more than the last time.
It's flying.
Mastering disaster in double quick fast time by flying. It's so inviting.
Exciting.
And quite edifying. Up in the substratosphere, soaring high in the sky.
And we now know why there is no feeling that's quite like the feeling of flying. Bumping your head on the ceiling of heaven above. It's so appealing, we're reeling in our depth of flying.
Say that, little Charlie Bucket, because from here on out, it's yours.
I'd love to. Well, I can't leave my family behind. Mom, Dad, and Grandma, Josephine, and Grandma.
There's no need to worry about that, Charlie. That's all been taken care of already.
What does this mean, Mr. Wonka?
It means your family can live here at the factory with you. So, what do you say, Charlie?
I say, yes. I would truly, positively, absolutely love to.
Watch out!